Me chide him. The Beagle Queen. Arigato gozaimasu. Minnie, come here. Mushy mushy. I'm trying to learn Japanese, okay? Okay, so anyways, this is Trader Joe's haul. So, the first two things I got are extremely boring, and it's just this artisan water, New Zealand, to cook with. And also, I always pick up two every time I go because, like, we're scheduled. Like, we're supposed to have an earthquake within the next year or two or five. I don't even know. But I want to be prepared for natural disaster, and water is number one. Read the book Sugar Blues, because what I'm about to say, you're going to think, what? That's crazy. How do you know that? Read the book Sugar Blues. But if you ever get into a situation where there's limited food supplies or water supply, let me just tell you this one fact, okay? You will die quicker eating sugar than if you didn't eat anything at all. So if you're stranded somewhere, let's say hypothetically, you're stranded in a candy factory, hypothetical, okay? And there's nothing to eat around you but mountains of sugar, candy, okay? Do not eat that sugar because it's gonna kill you faster than if you didn't eat anything at all. It's fact. Read the book Sugar Blues. I'm not making this up, people. But anyways, so what does that tell you about sugar? Should you be eating it? No. Because you will live longer if you honestly don't even eat anything. Not even water. You will live longer than if you ate sugar. It's true. It's true, girl. People get mad at this video. It's because I'm shattering their illusion. It's truth. That's scientific fact. But anyways, shredded green, red cabbage with orange carrots. I mean, it's just a standard. Just standard. Power to the greens, organic blend of baby kale, baby chard, baby spinach. Another staple. I got these organic blueberries because my friend had them at his house, and we were eating them the other day, and they were bomb. So I got them. And then I got these celery hearts to eat with some kind of nut butter. And it's like extra vegetables, you know, vegetable snack. You can't go wrong with eating more vegetables. That's the thing. When people always ask me, how do you like start to eat healthy? Just start to eat more vegetables. That's like the first step. Because people get in the mindset of people choose to change their eating habits for a variety of reasons. But the main reasons are to be healthier and to lose weight. Okay, that's just the motivation. So people always think that when they decide to, you know, change their eating habits, that it has to be drastic and crazy. And it's like, no, because how many times have you tried that in your own experience, and how many times has that worked out for you? Zero times. I know, girl. Because I've done that 1,000 times in my life. Okay, so I know. If you do it like this, this is gonna happen. It's cause and effect, yin and yang, macrobiotic life. But anyways, so it's better to do things more gradual to get yourself used to, oh, this little change, okay. After a while you're comfortable with it, this little change, okay. You know, it's better, it's more lasting, it's more impactful, it's more sustainable, it's more beneficial, makes most sense. It's like, it's better to create a slow, gradual change to become a habit rather than like, everything's different, I'm not used to any of this. It's just gonna make you wanna go back to your old ways. That's why the first thing when people ask me, like, oh, how do you eat healthier, blah, blah, blah. Just honestly, just eat more vegetables. And whatever that means to you. More vegetables, you can't go wrong. No one, no doctor, no, you know, dietitian, no one's gonna have a problem with that. Eat more vegetables. Makes the most sense, right? It's not cutting out anything. It's not cutting out anything, it's just adding. And this is the thing that they always told us in eating disorder treatment is not about taking away things. It's not about taking away things, it's about adding so much great stuff, and that can mean food, habits, you know, whatever into your life that those unhealthy habits, whatever it may be, food, behaviors, just get, because there's just too much goodness. It just gets pushed away. You don't need this anymore. Whereas you try to take, because whatever you have, whatever habit, food, behavior, whatever, that's unhealthy, detrimental to you in some way, whatever you have that for a reason, okay? You have that because it helps you to sustain whatever. It's like a comfort, whatever, okay? So if you try to just take that away, what are you left with? And you're like, So it's much better that, yeah, you keep your unhealthy habits or whatever, and you just slowly add healthier stuff and healthier stuff and healthier stuff. Too much, there's too much healthy stuff. Oh, I forgot. I forgot I used to think like that. I forgot that I used to eat that way, you know? It's just, oh. Am I making sense to anybody? Probably not. But anyways, that's why I'm not a professor. That's why I don't teach school. That's why I teach dance, people. Okay, but anyways, crumbled goat cheese. Because I like to put this on my pasta. And goat milk is not as extreme as cow's milk because a goat is smaller. But anyways, then I got these two juices that I always get, the strawberry chia with apple juice, and then the very green juice. Get it. Get them. They're bomb. Oh, so cool. Okay. Then I got these Persian cucumbers, organic, because I like to eat them, dip them in hummus and eat them. Or I like to cut them up and put them in sandwiches or whatever. Very cool. The water's cool and cleansing. Where's that from? Soulmate's body. Okay. Did you watch my dance video where I did an improv dance to that song? Maybe, because I was like 25 views, 27, 23, 20 something views. I'll link it down below in case you didn't see it and in case you're interested. Anyways, this is edamame hummus. It's my favorite hummus. It's the best. You should get it. It's the greatest. Oh my God. Okay. And then read the cancer prevention diet because it talks about soy products, because I know soy is like a controversial food, you know, but it's like everything can be bad, everything can be good. It's like, but you have to have the knowledge of when is it bad and when is it good and when is it okay, like every once in a while. So you have to have that knowledge because thinking like, oh, I can just never have soy, it's like, well, no, because there's evidence that soy actually helps prevent diseases, not cause them. And it's not just about soy, you feel me? It's about other factors. It's just the balance. It's just the balance. Yin and yang, macrobiotic life. Why do you think I'm into this, people? Because it's not black and white thinking. It's, you have to have the knowledge of when is it okay for me to have soy? What's the right balance that's okay? And when is it the wrong balance that it's like, no, I can't have that? So read the book, Cancer Prevention Diet by Michio Kushi. But anyways, I got these organic sugar snap peas because I like what I've been liking to do is like chop them up, like maybe like one of these peas, maybe like chop it into three pieces and like lightly steam them so they're like a little bit cooked, but they're still kind of crunchy. And I just, I do that with these broccoli and carrots, but I have to like chop them up because when they're smaller, they cook faster. And I lightly steam them and I put them in a bowl with brown rice or whatever kind of grain you want and whatever kind of beans you want. And then you could do your own flavoring, whatever you want to do. You can spray olive oil spray from Trader Joe's and do a little bit of ume plum vinegar. And it's like simple, quick, healthy. But anyway, speaking of easy, quick, but this is not as healthy, as the black bean and cheese taquitos. These are just bomb. Okay, I have to like limit myself of buying these too much because these are just so freaking good. And as you can tell, they're pre-made. So number one, that tells you it probably has extra shit in there that you don't really need. It's processed. It's processed. So it's not going to give you quality nutrients because it's already processed. And also the fact that you have to bake them is like very drying, so when you eat it, it's gonna be very drying to your body. So anyways, that's why I only buy these every once in a while, but they're so freaking good. Oh my god, I love them. And I plan on like making lazy people guacamole. Still haven't showed you guys how to make lazy people guacamole. Basically, you just mash up an avocado with whatever salsa and just put like a tiny bit of sea salt in there. That's it. It's like lazy people. But, so I plan on eating that. Maybe I'll make it tonight. Great. After I had these chips, that's a great idea, Michelle. But I'm very hungry, okay? But anyways, then I got these burgers. Quinoa cowboy veggie burgers with black beans and roasted corn. Honestly, they just looked good to me. Black beans, quinoa, and corn all mashed together in a patty. That sounds great to me, honestly. So I got these, so who knows. But they are processed, and they do have some fucked up shit in there. But I just wanted to try them, so. And I'm not dying from anything. That's the thing. But anyways, ugh. Minnie, you want to hide in this bag? You want to... Okay. Oh, look. And then they had this at Trader Joe's. They had a big old, like, display of jackfruit cans. I got it before my last, maybe a few Trader Joe's hauls back. And I haven't eaten it yet. But they sell jackfruit in a brine, in, like, canned. And then they had this recipe thing that people could take, and it's pooled jackfruit sandwich, and basically tells you how to make a pulled pork or whatever kind of sandwich, but like using jackfruit. So it says, you know, all the stuff. So it's like, let me take that because maybe I want to make it. So I got it. That's great. Then I got these organic corn flakes because this is just easy breakfast or snack. You don't have to think about it. And it's kind of light. So if you're like someone who struggles to have an appetite in the morning, because I know people are like that, and sometimes I even am like that. I don't have an appetite in the morning, but you really need to eat in the morning, you know? So those cornflakes are really light. So like it's easy. It's like quick, it's easy, it's light. So I mean, it's not going to be too much of a hassle trying to get an appetite for that because it's just like really light, you know, so. Then I got this organic unfiltered apple juice, which I always get, and it's great. I love it. So good. Especially you add some sparkling water to it and it's all chilled and you're like watching your shows, like whatever, and you're like, instead of drinking soda, you know, or whatever. Then I got this lavender chamomile hand soap for the bathroom because you don't want poop on your hands, do you? That's nasty if you do. That's really gross. That's like a sign of an imbalance. You should maybe check that out because it's not right, girl. But anyways, then then I got this organic beet strawberry juice. I got this just to drink, but then also, sometimes I make like frozen like fruit smoothies, and so I thought this might be good inside the smoothie whenever I make it. But it's not really a good idea to be eating like frozen stuff like that because it's very extreme, you know. But when it's really hot outside and you're like super stressed, it's like acceptable, you know. A little bit more acceptable. Ooh, 10% battery. That's great. Then I got these treats for Minnie. Chicken recipe jerky sticks. Jerky treats for puppies and dogs. Real chicken flavor. Oof. So, I usually get Minnie the brown rice and chicken organic treats, but they didn't have them. So I just got chicken for Minnie. Because I'm trying to get Minnie to be macrobiotic. She's pretty macrobiotic. I mean, she eats my brown rice and vegetables and beans when I don't eat them, which that's whole food. So like anybody, like humans, animals, they can eat that. But I'm getting this book. I talked about it at my Sprouts haul. I'm getting this book. It's called Raising Healthy Pets by Dr. Norman. I think his last name is Ralston, but he's a macrobiotic vet. So come here, Minnie. So he wrote a book about how to incorporate, macrobiotics for your pet, because it's the same thing with humans, to make your pet healthy, to make your pet more intuitive with the universe, to make your pet more comfortable, to live the best life your pet can live. Same thing with people, so it's just applied to pets, you know? So, I thought you wanted to be with me, Minnie. That's why you were getting all mad over there. But anyways, then I got this ginger because I want to start drinking the ginger daikon tea more frequently. It's like a macrobiotic remedy drink. And since I'm not drinking coffee anymore, I don't know. I just feel like I need like some kind of hot beverage. That's not gonna fuck me up, you know? Then I got this organic zucchini squash. Just more vegetables? I don't know. I'm just trying to get more vegetables. Just different vegetables. Just all the vegetables. Okay? Vegetables are really good for you. Then I got these organic avocados for whatever. I mean, avocados are pretty tropical. But it's a whole thing, people. I don't even have the energy to explain it to you. Even though avocados are more tropical, they are more yin. I read in the cancer prevention diet that because of global warming and climate change, it's becoming more acceptable for macrobiotic people to eat more yin food items because that's the way our climate is changing. It's changing warmer weather globally. So you have to adjust your diet to match the weather, to match the climate. You see? It's more about, feel like I'm losing people. Okay, macrobiotic eating is more than, oh, just don't eat meat. Oh, just don't eat any animal product. Is more to it than that. Okay? It's like, and there's different levels of eating. What do they call it? I don't even know, but there's different levels of eating. You know, the most standard level is like basic, like human survival, and the highest level is much more, you use your brain more. Like, it's not just like one level is just like to survive. That's the first level, is just eating to survive. And then the second level is like eating what tastes good, which is what most people are at, eating what tastes good. Then the third level is, what's the third level? Like cultural. Like, what does your culture eat? And then the fourth level is like, is like global, like, or ethical. Like, if I eat this ice cream, it's because everyone in the whole entire world can eat this ice cream. You feel me? Which, that's not possible, because not everyone can eat ice cream all over the world. People don't have that luxury all over the world. And then there's like spiritual level, like I eat this way because of my religion. And then there's health level, I eat this way for my health. And then there's, what, Minnie? Come here. I'm probably saying them like out of order and I'm probably missing a lot, but you know, it's more to it. Do you understand? Macrobiotic eating is more to it than just like, oh, just like don't eat sugar and like just don't eat meat and just like don't eat dairy. It's so great, you guys. You guys should do it. It's like, because that's like a low level. That's a low level of thinking, a low level of eating. It's more to it. It's more to it than that. Feel me? But anyways, I probably just made a whole bunch of people mad. I don't mean to make you mad, people. It's just the truth. That's it. It's just the truth. Check it out for yourself. Tell me I'm wrong. Check it out first, because you won't understand if you check it out. It's like you just get mad because you don't understand. But if you understood, you're like, oh yeah, yeah, that's right. But anyways, organic whole carrots, because it's just a standard. And then I got these corn and wheat tortillas. These are so good. I mean, the healthier version would be just like plain like corn tortillas. Oh my god, they smell so good. I just love these. I love these. And I plan to make tacos with these. Jackfruit with jackfruit. Like I had at that farmer's market. Oh my god. And then the last thing I got is a cantaloupe. Organic cantaloupe. Because they were out of organic mini watermelons, which was what I was planning to get. But I decided to get this cantaloupe because I love cantaloupes too, and it's just as small as a mini watermelon, and it's organic, and it's fruit, and it's delicious, so. Ooh, it's cooling my face off. But anyways, thanks for watching this video. I'm extremely hungry and tired, and it's been a long day. So I apologize if I was incoherent, or maybe I offended you. Just thank you for watching this video. See you guys in the next one.